When we presented the planting plan to Gary and Crystal, at Gary's request, we included a small lawn area along the sidewalk. At the same time, we suggested the idea of a turf substitute. We should have guessed that the appeal of not having to mow the lawn would win out. Gary came back and asked us to suggest some lawn substitutes. We considered some options, such as yarrow, ground cover sages, and some grasses. We finally settled on San Diego sedge following a visit to the garden in the San Gabriel foothills.
I'd like to introduce you to Cassie Awiyagi with Form LA Landscaping, a design, build, and maintenance landscape company. And we're here today, Cassie has invited us to talk about Carex Panza and Carex Glauca at this garden. Cassie, can you tell us a little bit about the planting here?
Yeah, we had a lot of fun here. We worked with two different types of sedge. One is Carex Glauca and one is Carex Panza. And the sedge family has an incredibly broad range throughout California, which is one of the reasons why it offers so much to our garden setting. It takes very little water, a full variety of sun and shade conditions, very, very low maintenance, and all kinds of versatility when it comes to using it in designs.
Now, it's a very distinctive look. It's a very meadow-like look on this Carex Panza in the foreground. Is that always the way it looks?
Well, this is the way we've designed it to look in this condition. We've let it grow to become a natural meadow, but in contrast, you can actually use the Carex Panza as a lawn substitute, where you're going to be saving potentially 30 to 70% water on your water bill, mm-hmm. and mow it regularly to become just a normal lawn where kids and dogs and the whole family can play on it.
Great. So, but I'm guessing you wouldn't mow this quite as low as a Bermuda grass or a regular lawn.
No, we would use the highest setting on the mower, and that would be at about 2.5 inches high. And that also helps preserve the water and reduce the maintenance the higher you keep the lawn. But it actually has a fairly pristine look, similar to a lawn, but just enough variation so that all the types of activities that take place, the dogs, the kids, allows it just to really look natural and doesn't really highlight any flaws that happen from any kind of activity.
That's great. So let's talk a little bit about planting this. Is this something that you would buy in sod or in 1 gallons, or how do you buy it?
Well, you actually you can buy it in 1 gallons, but because we use so much of it and the design intent was to use it as a full coverage meadow, we actually bought these in what's called rose liners or plugs. Mm-hmm. So they're very small little liners. The grasses might start at a few inches tall, and if you're lucky, maybe an inch girth. So we plant them about 12 inches apart, so you have a lot of space in between them, and that's how it looks when it goes in.
So I imagine you would do some weed control before planting.
Yes, we always warn our clients and anyone who's interested in using this that the startup and establishment and maintenance to get a meadow going is a little bit more intensive than your average plant. One of the reasons is because we do 6 to 12 inch spacing, mm-hmm. you have all of this empty space in between that definitely is an opportunity for weeds to come in, and they definitely take hold. So mm-hmm. coming in here, weeding every other week, keeping it clear and making sure that the sedge has all the opportunity to grow is what's important in getting it established properly.
Right. I suppose that's the advantage of hiring a landscape firm that does the maintenance also.
Yes, yeah. When we design it, we feel responsible for maintaining it as well.
Yeah. Well, we're looking across the Carex Panza, and beyond that is some Carex Glauca.
Yes.
And that appears to be in really deep shade at the moment.
Yep, that actually spends most of its day in deep shade. It gets a little bit at the very end of the day, some very afternoon sun during certain times of the mm-hmm. year, but clearly it's performing amazingly in the shade. Mm-hmm. And one of the things I like about the Carex Glauca is that it has a blue tint to it. Mm-hmm. So in the dark areas of the shade where you want to have a punch of bright foliage, mm-hmm. the blue kind of changes it up a little bit, and in contrast to the deeper greens around it, it adds some color, and in shade it's a little bit hard to always get your color.
And yet it gives you this full ground cover effect.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. And people struggle with shade situations, and
yes.
we just want you to know that once this stuff gets established, it's mm-hmm. it's a no-brainer.
So before we move off from here, Tell us a little bit about the irrigation that you put in here.
Well, you can irrigate these meadows in either overhead spray or subsurface irrigation. We actually have irrigated this with overhead spray, which with MP rotator nozzles, which is a lower flow, low water usage device. What that does is that puts the water out at such a slow rate that it's very slow to run off, and gets more of that water to the roots of the plants.
Which is a real advantage in this slope condition here.
Right, yeah. Exactly. And one of the things I had mentioned about the 30 to 70% water savings is that once this lawn gets established, you can actually get away with potentially once a week watering on a on a meadow substitute lawn, whereas in the middle of summertime with a traditional lawn, you're watering almost every day or more than once a day to keep it green. So it's energy, all that maintenance you did on the front end pays off.